Get ready to match the stars. William Shatner, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Julie Harris, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson and friends. I greet you.
It's always a pleasure to see all of you, our three regulars. Brett Summer, have you got it together, Brett?
Not really, but I'm trying very hard because they said on stage.
And Charles Nelson Reilly.
Yes, sir.
And Richard Dawson. Those are our three regulars. And naturally, we're very pleased to welcome our guests for the performance
here. An irregular.
William Shatner, who comes to us from, from Barbary Coast.
Barbary Coast.
Yes.
Terrific.
And this sweet and gifted lady who comes to us from the family Holvac. And what's the name of the film?
The Hiding Place.
The Hiding Place, indeed. And you. Where do you come to us from, Fanny Flagg?
I come from the Annie Ray Hutton story.
How about that?
Jane.
All right, now let's say hello to our two players here, Michael Albacton and Harriet Rasmussen.
That's pretty good, Gene. We spent an hour there now.
We welcome both of you. I guess our cup overfloweth. We have Mr. Albacton and Miss Rasmussen. I want to find out a little bit about each of you. Harriet, would you tell us the story of your life in 8 seconds?
Oh, let me see. I'm from Spring, Texas, which is just north of Houston. I'm married.
Yes.
I have three great teenagers, the oldest, which is a freshman at Texas A&M. I like to bowl, I like to swim, well, I like to do everything. And since the centennial year, I love America and everybody in it, and I love Match Game.
Well, good for you, Harriet. That says it all. Thank you. All right, Michael. This show is called Can You Top This? Go ahead. Follow that act.
I'll give it a try. Live in Santa Monica.
Yeah.
Single, 35. I'm in the building business. Handle marketing for subcontractors to builders.
Uh-huh.
And I just enjoy having a good time.
Well, you can have a good time here.
I hope
you
so.
You really are.
I am.
I want to remind both of you that you'll be trying to match as many of our celebrities as you can. Now, what is it? You have a question already.
Did he say he was single and 35?
He's single and 35.
Does he like older women?
He says... thumbs up to older women, says Michael.
Someone much younger than yourself?
That's enough of that.
Both of you will be trying to match as many of our celebrities as you can, and the winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. All right, Harriet, I call on you and ask you to make a selection. You want A or B?
B.
B it is, and here we go. The doctor said to the new mother, "Madam, I think you've been watching too much television. Your baby looks just like blank." Doctor said to the new mother, "Madam, I think you've been watching too much television. Your baby looks just like blank."
Well, I like her accent. Does she have a good accent?
She's had a marvelous accent.
Do you think she sounds like Anjali?
Yeah.
She took elocution lessons from Julie Harris here. And just peek at that. Oh, yes, of course. All right, the three lower tiers ready. Everybody ready up there? So, Harriet Rasmussen. The doctor said to the new mother, "Madam, I think you've been watching too much television. Your baby looks just like..."
"You."
What?
"You."
"Your baby looks just like Gene Rayburn?"
"Yes."
Oh, that's a very sweet thought. I thank you for that, Harriet. Before they wheel you off, I just want to give you a little kiss for that sweet idea.
Now, the bad news is it's a girl.
Oh, Oh, Bill, what'd you say?
Pink and cuddly. And,
yes, I am.
And dripping.
No.
No. Oh. And wrinkled because your baby looks like a test pattern.
But you really have been taking dumb pills, haven't
dumb.
You?
I take them by the carload.
What'd you say, Brett?
I said your baby looks just like the Planet of the Apes.
That sweet lady's looking for the sensible answer, Gene Rayburn.
If you want a sweet baby, get a baby that looks just like Walter Cronkite.
Is he weird? Is he weird?
He's wonderful.
Oh, he's wonderful, but
she's
wonderfully
my friend.
Weird. All right. Madam, you've been watching too much television. Your baby looks just like Gene Rayburn, according to Harriet. What do you say?
I say Beretta.
Beretta. Well, here we go.
Well, I say a very similar thing.
What?
Beretta.
Beretta. Okay, no one's come to my answer yet. If I were sitting in one
well,
of your seats,
you, but we
I would have
to
said
that on the nose.
Well, no,
about.
I wouldn't have said myself.
Give me your answer.
No, I won't say.
I'd
you,
rather do yours, really.
You show me yours before I show you mine. Now let's go.
Well, that's one of the oldest tricks.
No, come
in the
on.
World.
No, I'll never show you mine.
Come on, you got to show yours now, right now.
I said a test pattern.
No. Now listen.
Wait a minute.
When babies,
how can you boo the flag?
That is star-spangled. It's really moving. When a child comes into this vale of tears,
yes.
Doesn't it come in most often without hair?
Yeah.
Well, don't they all look like Kojak? Yeah. How come nobody said that? Is that the answer?
Not at all. Yeah. Those babies are born with hair.
No, they're not. Anyway, I'm sorry you didn't score with that because it was a sweet idea. I thank you. Michael, this is yours. 110-year-old Mrs. Periwinkle said,
my husband is like my car. Not bad. He needs a new blank. Just like my car. My husband is just like my car. He needs a new blank. Madam? Splendid.
All right. I love you when you're old.
Will you love me when I'm old and gray? Here we go, Michael L. Bacton. 110-year-old Mrs. Periwinkle said,
my husband is like my car. He needs a new...
How about a starter?
Starter! Very good! He catches on. Did you catch on?
Well, I tell you...
What?
I need a new lube job.
A new lube job. Okay. All right, Brett. You may dispose of it now, if you would.
Well, I put it. It's been so long.
Brett?
Yes, dear?
May we see your card, please?
I said he needed a new battery.
New battery? That would help. Charles?
I said the same as my sweet darling. Hi, baby. I said battery.
Battery. Michael says,
my husband is like my car. He needs a new starter.
Starter?
Starter, you said. By Jove, she said it. Richard, what do you say about old Mrs. Periwinkle?
Well, the old codger, what happened?
I said,
read it to
husband,
me again.
My husband is like my car.
Well, don't do King Lear, just read the question. The Emmys have been given out already.
He needs a new... You are a handsome young man.
You like younger men?
Yes, I do.
Well, go over to him, you hamburger.
He needs a new starter, according to Michael.
No, sir. He needs a new piston.
Oh.
Yes,
As long as I'm over here, I might as well look at yours, too, to make it a match even half dozen.
Hi.
Hi.
You probably don't remember her.
You remember? I'm Mrs. Periwinkle. You remember me, honey?
Didn't you used to work under a different name?
No. What do you say? My husband needs, yeah, is like my car. He needs a new...
I was going to say safety device, but I said battery.
You said battery,
yeah,
yes.
I said that. You know why?
Yes, why?
Because I was wrong.
Wrong.
Michael, you got one there. So at the end of round one, the score is 1-0 in favor of Michael. Right. Round two coming up in a moment or so, but right now, pay attention to this. Hello there. Now we go to round two. With my magic finger, I push the button, reveal our round two questions. Let's see. Michael, you're in the lead, so we ask you to make a selection here, A or B.
Let's go for A.
A it is. Everyone except Miss Julie Harris, you do not play.
No.
You lay out, okay? The rest of you... The rest
southern
of you...
Expression.
It's a southern expression.
Meaning?
Meaning, do not write.
That's not what they told me it meant.
Sammy the Spritter runs like a rocket because before every race, he fills up with blank.
Hey, I think I missed the operative word.
Sammy the Sprinter runs like a rocket because before every race, he fills up with blank.
You see what Charles is doing? He who steals from me is pretending that I'm going to steal from him.
Why are you looking over here?
Sammy the Sprinter...
He runs like a rocket because before every race, he fills up with...
Gotcha! What?
Finished? You haven't even started. You haven't put pen to paper yet. Okay, you got it.
Sammy the Sprinter. Right. Is everybody finished except me?
We're all standing around. We're running out of music, and we're...
Oh, honey, dear. I'm sorry. I don't know what's happened to me.
Okay.
I need to be so quick.
Now, Michael, Sammy the Sprinter runs like a rocket because... Before every race, he fills up with...
Beans.
Yes, Sir William?
That's an ill wind that blows no one. I figure, fly me to the moon.
Moonshine.
Moonshine.
Moonshine. All right. I don't know whether that would speed him up or not. Brett, what did you say?
I had to hurry along and I felt so bad about my answer, but this may be a match. What happens when you fill up with beans?
I don't care to know.
You get full of hot air.
Okay. All right, no match there. Charles?
I think your answer needs clarification. Baked beans.
Baked beans. Now, Richard... The question goes as follows. Sammy the Sprinter runs like a rocket because before every race, he fills up with...
I give up. What's he fill up with?
I don't know. He said beans.
So did I.
You said beans, too. Miss Fanny Flag, honey.
Hi. I have something to pose to you.
Yes.
He eats beans to run. When he jumps the hurdles, does he eat jumping beans?
Yes, Mexican jumping beans.
I see.
Precisely.
I gave the result. I said gas.
Yeah. Okay. So, now, Michael, you have a total of 3, and as we go to Harriet, I say to you, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win. All right, here it is.
Okay.
Manuel, the bullfighter.
See?
He said, oh, my new Toreador pants are so tight. I tell you, the only way I can get them on is to blank my legs. My new Toreador pants are so tight, the only way I can get them on is to blank my legs.
Are so tight.
Any questions?
Yeah.
Okay, I think I got.
Oh, ho, ho. You finish. My new Toreador pants, very tight.
I'm very fine.
All right.
Okay.
Okay. Finish. Okay, Harriet. Manuel the bullfighter, he said. My new Toreador pants are so tight. The only way I can get them on is to blank my legs.
Shrink.
Shrink my legs. I think they're trying to tell you something, Harriet. What'd you say, William?
Well, he's liable to slip and slide into his pants. I said grease.
Grease my legs would be a good one. That's a good one. Okay.
Kind of got the smarts, Brett.
Harriet, don't pay any attention to a group groan. You just pay attention to me, darling. I said shrink.
Shrink. Charles, what about this toreador?
What I told you to do the other night, sugar, shave your legs.
Up with that.
Now, score at this moment is 3-1. And Julie Harris, what do you say?
I say he has to squeeze his legs.
Squeeze his legs. All right. That'll do it, I suppose. Now, she's looking for the answer. Shrink the legs. The only way I can get my toreador pants on is to shrink my legs. What do you say, Richard?
Don, I say grease or oil.
Grease and or oil. So Michael wins the game. And she says, Everything here. You stand by for a moment or so while we say goodbye to Harriet. It was a pleasure meeting you, my dear, and we've got some gifts for Harriet Rasmussen. Goodbye. Thank you. Bye. Now, while she's spinning off, we've got to spin a few messages for you. Pay attention. How do you feel? Here we are with Michael Albecton. Are you ready, Michael, to have a go at it? It's time now for the Big Money Super Match where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you, and whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. Here we go with the first one. We polled a recent studio audience, Michael, and we got their best response to this. Nature Blank. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you team up with the next one, you get $250. If you match the bottom one, you get $100. Now, three of our celebrities are permitted to assist. Whom do you call on?
Oh, let's see. How about Brett?
Brett? Wait a minute, one at a time here. Brett, let's get an answer from her.
Wait a minute, we go together. Brett and Charles is the right kind of thing.
Okay, all right, you want Brett and Charles.
Jason Sanborn, Brett and Butter, and Brett and Charles.
Okay.
Orville and Willie, what was the other one's name?
Brett, have you got an answer here?
Null and Void?
Yes, that's it.
Duncan Wagnall.
What do you say?
Well, the other name is Nature Boy.
Nature Boy. Old song, right? Charles?
Nature's Way.
Nature's Way. He added an S to it, an apostrophe S.
Fanny?
Nature Lover.
Nature Lover. They have those. Nature Lover, Nature's Way, and Nature Boy. Michael, do you want one of those, or have you got a better idea?
I think Nature Boy.
Nature Boy.
Yeah.
Well, what a boy. Okay, Nature Boy is what he wants. We're going to find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Nature calls.
Excuse me.
You didn't raise your hand.
Not nice to call Mother Nature.
That's right. Nature Boy is what we want. Let's find out if Nature Boy's honey ended a $250 response. Nature Boy it is. Congratulations, Michael. You got it. Very good. Okay. What do you think's under the big one?
Lover.
Nature Lover?
Oh, Michael.
Study. All right. Here it is. Lover is right.
Very good.
Now, you've won $250, which means the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. And at this point, Michael, we're going to see how much more you can win with your second audience match. And here we go. We polled a recent audience and got their response to this. Blank McGraw. All right, let's see what kind of help your celebrities will give you now.
Richard?
Well, that's right up my alley.
Allie McGraw. Right. Gotcha.
But, Fanny, please.
Fanny.
Come here, Richard.
Wait a minute. What are you doing here? You leave him alone. He's mine. You leave him alone.
Quick draw, McGraw.
Quick draw, McGraw. You got two now.
Brett?
Have you got one, Brett?
Well, no offense, but I'm stuck with Charles McGraw.
Charles McGraw. Yes, okay, so you got Charles McGraw, Quick Draw McGraw, and Allie McGraw. Do any of those appeal to you?
Quick Draw McGraw.
Yeah.
Come in. Really? All right, let's find out if Quick Draw McGraw is handling. All right. Quick Draw McGraw, are you under the $100 response? Tug McGraw.
To me who Tug McGraw is.
Tug McGraw is a baseball player.
Yeah. You have a rope and two teams.
Quick Draw McGraw. Let's look at the $250 response. Quick Draw McGraw. You got it again in the same spot. Congratulations. What do you think is under the big one there?
What do you think,
sir? Allie.
Who gave you that cold drink?
Allie McGraw's up
Allie
there.
McGraw.
Let's slide it, Earl.
What a broad.
Allie McGraw's up there. Now, you've won another $250. We multiply that by 10, gives you another $2,500. Added to the previous one, you got a pot of $5,000 to shoot for. To collect it, you got to match one of them head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. And, Michael, you face me, and here it is. It's worth $5,000. It goes like this. Ace of blank. Ace of blank. Okay, he's finished. Michael, what answer do you want to give which you think will match his? Ace of blank.
Ace of spades.
All right. Richard, for $1,000, $5,000, it says ace of spades will match you. What do you say?
Card of death.
Yo, really?
So is this one.
So is that one. Oh, you got $5,500. Congratulations. Well done. How do you feel?
Fantastic.
Atta boy. Well, he feels fantastic. This is going to make you feel good, too. Pay attention. This fellow is a very most happy fella. Michael Albecton has just won $5,500, and I was wondering if he has any idea what he's going to do with all that loot.
I'm going to make an awful lot of my creditors happy.
You got
bunches.
Well, aren't they overjoyed to hear from you, Michael?
They have got to be.
Well, we wish you the very, very best of luck, and we thank you for being here. We thank you. You were all splendid, and we hope you'll join us next time for Match Game PM. Goodbye.
Come, contestants.